ChatGPT has taken the internet by storm. It's a general-purpose AI chatbot developed by OpenAI, a company researching machine learning models. You may have already seen some of those chats, as Twitter and Reddit were flooded with those for days. Even some developers took the chatbot to a test and got some pretty impressive results. But how good is it really? In this video, I'm gonna build a very minimalist Twitter clone using ChatGPT to find out exactly that. So we're gonna build a pretty simple application, which has two main reasons. First, I'm a really lazy person, and second, I expect to be very annoyed by this AI chatbot very soon. We'll let the chatbot program a web application with two entities, users and tweets. There will also be two relationships, one that allows a user to post tweets and another one that allows users to follow each other. First, let's ask ChatGPT to set up our project. I told it what framework I wanted to use and what dependencies I wanted to be installed. Also, can I just point out that I was very nice at the beginning of this project, saying please in every message to the chatbot? This will change very soon though. So at the start, we had a slight misunderstanding about the frontend framework I wanted to use, but I clarified that and they understood. And now we're on good terms, I think. It's hard to tell with those bots. Anyways, I used the programmer's strongest skill there is, pressed the enter key in my terminal, and well, those red tags are not usually what you're looking for. It did try to install the dependencies before initializing the project itself, which is simply not how anything works. So I got back to the chatbot and told it to fix this mess. At this point, I felt like a really bad teacher, just shouting at the AI what it did wrong instead of explaining anything. But it worked? Green text finally appeared on my screen, so we can finally take a first look at the application that will take down Twitter once and for all. The login and registration, as well as the boilerplate interface, is provided by the web framework itself. But now, let's get this AI to actually code something. I quickly learned that I had to be really specific about what I wanted the chatbot to do, so my chat messages got longer and more detailed. It managed to generate the code for my entities and relationships quite quickly. There were some minor mistakes, but overall, it wasn't too bad. At this point, I felt like I was reading a tutorial that was written just for me. The chatbot asked me to use a combination of terminal commands and code snippets that I copied and pasted into my terminal. Was I the student now? When we started to build the part where you can actually follow other people, there were some bumps in the road, but nothing major. It used attributes that didn't exist and API endpoints that weren't created yet, but I used them as a guide to generate more code. Life was good. I was living the dream. The AI was giving me instructions to follow, and I listened, copied, and repeated. So, let me set the record straight on this. ChatGPT sucks at CSS. Like, it's so bad, I cannot even express how much I hated doing CSS with this chatbot. It didn't understand how flexboxes work at all, and it destroyed my layout multiple times. I wanted to smash my keyboard on the desk so bad. I only managed to not make it look like an interface from 2010 by writing really specific instructions on what classes to add. I found myself telling the AI to talk less in every other message. And the pain just kept going. I started to work on the timeline and the post-tweet interface. But eventually, it was done. For the coding side, the chatbot did some really weird stuff when sorting the tweets, but it somewhat worked out. I had to go to Stack Overflow though to fix the issue, so that's an L. It also decided to create a new HTML attribute on a text area named placeholder color. Well, I guess I'm gonna tell W3C and WebRTC about that. Also, the time formatting function that it made was a little weird. It was not wrong, but I like having leading zeros on my minutes and seconds. It just looks so wrong, but maybe it's just me. So that's it. We can find users, follow and unfollow them, and see their tweets in our timeline. We can also send tweets ourselves. We're just gonna add a cat as a logo for no specific reason whatsoever. And we're done. I'm absolutely sure that AI code generation will be a standard tool for programmers one day, but this day is not here yet, at least for me. Debugging code that's not written by yourself is, generally speaking, not the most enjoyable way to write an application. And it's no different for AI-generated code. There were still a lot of things that had to be fixed after the code was generated. But I should mention that some of those problems are probably due to the knowledge cutoff of ChatGPT. As ChatGPT does not have a connection to the internet, it cannot explore new information. That means that it has only knowledge about the data that it has been trained with. ChatGPT does not have any knowledge of the world past September 2021. Libraries and frameworks have changed since then. And even if frameworks and libraries have changed their APIs before that knowledge cutoff, there's still a lot of tutorials and resources with old code out there. Generally speaking, when I gave the AI a piece of code and I wanted it to make a small change, it was pretty decent at it, if it was not CSS. For more complex problems, the AI struggled to come up with solutions or ideas that were as good as or better than what I had in mind. Even when the AI was wrong, it was very confident with its answers. Just like one of those rich white startup CEO dudes that has no idea what's actually going on but likes to talk a lot. Most of the explanations were correct, but you should definitely not rely on them alone. And keep in mind, the chatbot will provide you with wrong answers in a very confident manner from time to time. The programming part took me about 5 hours, which isn't too bad overall. The chatbot completed most tasks, even though it needed a few extra messages to get the full picture sometimes. The solutions were pretty much never complete or 100% correct though. You can use the answers of the AI as a guide to further debug your application until it works. The question remains if this is a good approach to application design. There are also other solutions than ChatGPT out there. GitHub Copilot, for example, specializes on AI suggestions directly in your editor, and it can also learn from your codebase. This sounds like a better solution in theory, although when I tested it a few months ago, I felt like it was more in my way than it actually helped me, so I uninstalled it again. You can find the code in the GitHub repo that is linked in the description. And while you're down there, feel free to share your experiences with ChatGPT in the comments. Also, if you made it this far into the video, consider leaving a like and subscribe to the channel, because this is actually the first video on this channel and 0% of my viewers are subscribed right now.